George Edward Rube Waddell may have been the strangest man ever to play in the big leagues. A farmer's son from Punxsutawney, Pennsylvania, he possessed a fastball fearsome enough and a curve wicked enough to lead the American League in strikeouts for 6 straight years and to outpitch Cy Young for 20 innings. But it was his personality that most people remembered. He poured ice water on his arm before he pitched because he said otherwise he'd burn up the catcher's glove. And when he won a game, he sometimes turned cartwheels on the mound. He drank too much. The sporting news called him the Southpaw, and he couldn't quite remember how many women he'd married. Between seasons, Waddell wrestled alligators and toured in a vaudeville melodrama, The Stain of Guilt. On the field, his attention tended to wander. Opponents could break his concentration by holding up puppies or bright, shiny toys. He loved fires, and when a fire bell clanged, he had to be restrained from leaving the game to chase the fire engine. Exasperated teammates and opposing players never knew what he'd do next, but fans loved him.
Sunday would come and the little park would be packed way before game time. Everybody wanting to see the great Rube Waddell pitch. Nowhere to be found. Manager'd be having a fit. And then just a few minutes before the game time, there'd be a commotion in the grandstand. You'd hear people laughing and yelling, "Here comes Rube! Here comes Rube!" And there he'd come right through the stands. He jumped down on the field, cut across the infield, the clubhouse, taking off his shirt as he went. In about 3 minutes, he never wore any underwear, he'd run back out in uniform and yell, "All right, let's get him." Sam Crawford.
Players like Waddell, with their drinking, with their bad acting, with their inability to take their profession seriously, they came to baseball in its early years in very large numbers because baseball, though popular, was outside social norms. The instability of a career where you might work for a year or two and then be gone, the jumping from team to team seemed to be suited toward individuals who couldn't fit as well in the rest of society. Now, it helped in the case of Rube Waddell and many of these other sociopathic figures that in addition to being sociopaths, they also had incredibly strong arms or very good batting eyes.